We all feel drained after a long day at work, like your brain's just done for the day, even if your body's not. Now imagine feeling that kind of mental exhaustion all the time, even when you haven't done much at all. That's what it's like for many people living with Parkinson's disease. Most people hear Parkinson's and think of shaking hands or stiff muscles. But there's another symptom that's just as tough and way less talked about: mental fatigue. Hi, I'm Lama, and I'm a science storyteller. Parkinson's disease affects the brain. It's a long-term condition that mostly shows up through movement problems, like tremors, slowness, or muscle stiffness. But it doesn't stop there. Parkinson's also messes with things like mood, memory, focus, and motivation. One key brain chemical called dopamine starts to disappear. And when that happens, a lot more than movement gets harder. Mental fatigue isn't just feeling tired. It's more like your brain battery won't charge. People with Parkinson's describe it as a deep fog, where even simple things like having a conversation or making a small decision can feel overwhelming. Around half the people with Parkinson's report feeling this kind of constant mental dip. It can affect work, relationship, and everyday life. But because you can't see it like a tremor, it often gets ignored. So what does dopamine have to do with all this? Dopamine is often called the brain's feel-good chemical. But really, it's about motivation and drive. It helps your brain get going on tasks, stay focused, and feel rewarded when you finish something. In Parkinson's, the brain makes less dopamine. That's why movement gets harder. But it also explains why people feel mentally stuck, unmotivated, or just unable to start things. It's not that they don't want to, their brain can't get going. Even doing something they used to enjoy can suddenly feel impossible. By the way, I've made a whole video diving deeper into how dopamine affects mental energy and fatigue. If you're curious, I'll link it below and at the end of this video. Now, you might think, if the problem is low dopamine, can we just get more of it? Well, it's not that simple. There are medications like levodopa that help boost dopamine levels. And they do help, especially with movement. But when it comes to mental fatigue, they don't always fix the problem. Sometimes the effect of these medications wears off too soon, or the brain becomes more sensitive to the ups and downs in dopamine. That's why doctors and researchers are also looking at other ways to help. Things like talking therapies to manage mental strain, regular exercise which boosts brain health, brain stimulation techniques, and even mindfulness or relaxation tools. Here's the big idea. Mental fatigue in Parkinson's isn't just a side effect. It's a major part of the disease, and it deserves real attention. When we understand how the brain's motivation system breaks down, we stop blaming people for being lazy or unfocused, and we start giving them the support they actually need. Because Parkinson's isn't just about shaking hands. It's also about heavy thoughts, cloudy focus, and the invisible weight of mental exhaustion. And when we treat that just as seriously as the physical symptoms, we help people not just move better, but live better. Before you go, if you've been enjoying Llama Science and want to support what I do here, I've added a Ko-fi link below. Ko-fi is a simple platform where you can make small, one-time donations, kind of like buying me a coffee. And what's cool about this platform, you don't need to fuss about registering or making a profile. And it really helps me keep making this kind of content. Thanks for watching. If this gave you a new perspective on Parkinson's, please like and share it. And for more science made simple, don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next one.